welcome to Microsoft Azure Data Self-Help Series. My name is Kenny Yu, and I work on the SQL Server team. Today, I'll go over some tips and best practices to help you troubleshoot SQL Server slowness and improve performance. Before we start, it is essential to follow SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machine best practices. Selecting the correct VM size and storage type prevent future impact on performance. Here are some topics to consider when deploying an Azure VM. And for a more detailed explanation, please visit Microsoft's website. Perf Insight is a tool available to troubleshoot performance issues. Perf Insight is available in the VM Blay under the Help section and by selecting Performance Diagnostics. It will help diagnose the problem and suggest solutions. To run Perf Insight, select Run Diagnostics. There are several different types of analysis that can be run. Enter the support request if you have one. This will provide Microsoft with the diagnostic report. The report will take a few minutes to complete. The diagnostic tool will display current issue and suggest solutions. Each tab will display a short summary or recommendation. For a detailed summary, you can download the report. Perf Insights can be run locally in the virtual machine through command line. For more information, visit Microsoft's website. After the report has been downloaded, unzip the file and click on the Perf Insight report.html. The Perf Insight report is divided into different tabs. Each tab will contain relevant information on performance and findings. If the workload is I/O intensive, consider using premium storage, which is high performance storage for Azure Virtual Machines. Azure Virtual Machines and storage have IHOPs and throughput performance limits based on the type and size. When the application requests more IHOPs or throughput than what is allocated for the virtual machine or storage, your application's performance is capped. To see what max limits for each disk is, select Disks under Settings. To change the disk tier to the next size, which can help increase performance, click on the disk name and select Size plus Performance. The drop-down menu will provide the type, and each column will display the IHOPs and throughput limit. Downgrading a disk to a smaller size is not supported. Another option is to scale up the virtual machine to a different virtual machine type or series for increased performance. To do this, select size in the settings blade of the virtual machine. Each column will display the VM size, RAM, IHOPs, and costs. To select a different series, select the drop-down menu. Once the size is selected, click on Resize. It is also essential to follow Microsoft caching recommendations for data files and log files, which can help improve performance. To change caching settings, select Disk under Settings. Select the last column, name Host Caching. For data file disk, set Host Caching to Read-Only. For log file disk, set Host Caching to None. Do not enable read-write caching on disk for SQL Server data files. Always stop SQL Server service before changing the caching settings on your disk. In this video, we went over tips and best practices to help troubleshoot SQL Server slowness and improve performance. Please see our troubleshooting guides for more information. Thanks for your efforts. We hope the information in this video has been helpful to you.